We're not done yet. We came out, we did what we were supposed to do, but we still got work to do. I hope everybody start believing in us, because we're going to keep working.
It's game one of the NBA Finals, and Orlando is looking to take down the Lakers here at the Staples Center tonight.
Number one, baby!
Go Lakers, baby!
Yeah! Oh, championship! Championship ring, boy!
Disneyland!
Disney World!
Go Lakers! Yeah! This is where the journey's gonna end, baby! The real King's Court!
We're going to a hostile environment, but we up for the challenge. We're a good role team, so they got their work cut out for them.
61 years in the league for the Lakers. They've been to the finals 30 times now. Complete opposite side with Orlando. Just their second finals appearance.
They don't need to get nervous. It's basketball. It's basketball.
First game is always, you know, the toughest game because both teams will fill each other out. This sets the tone for the rest of the series.
Los Angeles looks poised to hang their 10th NBA championship banner, but only if they can avoid the upset by the Magic, who have already knocked off two of the top three teams in the playoffs.
They don't have to give you any respect. The media, the fans, nothing. But the thing they can't take away from you is winning games.
How we feeling? How we feeling? Go for the champions. Let's go. Let's go. Hey, what's up? Let's go. The time is in. Game time. Who?
Rash and loose, Dwight Howard led his Magic into Game 1, only to be swarmed by Lakers everywhere he turned.
The defense on Howard has been just terrific. That's good, hard basketball play by the Lakers.
While Howard was being shut down, the Lakers' leading man assumed his starring role.
Bryant with the ball outside the arc. Using a Bynum screen, gets to the right, hit shot, good! Boy, well defended, and Kobe rises up and knocks it down.
We're excited to be back in this situation. You know, we've been waiting for this moment all year, and now the time's here. And I wanted to make sure we got off to a good start.
Bryant comes to the top, deflected by Nelson, right back to Kobe. Spins left elbow, spins again, here's a shot, good! Oh, that is unstoppable!
An impossible shot by Bryant.
With Kobe lifting the Lakers into a halftime lead, the Magic were left to regroup.
Our defensive disposition has got to change, and it's got to change now.
But 7 years without a title had fueled Kobe Bryant's intense hunger to win. And with another chance at hand, he was determined to seize it.
Jab stepping on Petras, moves to the right, between the legs to the left. Kobe pushes back to the basket, spins in, and shoots, and hits, and he was fouled! It is a clinic from a very focused Kobe Bryant.
They own the Magic since the end of the first quarter.
When he does his expression on like that, he's ready to roll, and it's a great feeling.
Right back to Bryant. Courtney Lee will guard him, and the fans come to their feet at Staples. Across the midcourt line, dancing to the left around the screen. Bryant in the lane, goes all the way. Right hand layup, good.
Kobe Bryant, brilliant here in the third quarter, and the Lakers up by 22.
He's got the good old-fashioned blow right now in game one of the finals.
It's amazing when he goes off and he's able to do that, and he definitely pushed it in that game. He put us up big numbers, and then we were able to just capitalize on that as a team.
Scoring virtually at will, Kobe had 18 points in the third quarter alone, turning game one into a Laker rout.
The Lakers throwing the first punch in this 09 championship series, and what an uppercut it was.
Kobe Bryant, a brilliant performance, 40 points, highest he's ever had in a finals game, and a long night with Dwight Howard.
It's pretty hard to find a champion who hasn't, at some point in their playoff run, gotten their butts beat by 20-plus. The margin, it's disappointing, but it's still one win for them. They don't get two for it.
I just want it so bad. I just want it really bad. So, you know, it's just, you just put everything you have into the game, and then, you know, your emotions kind of flow out of you.
For Kobe Bryant, Game 1 was just the latest in a long line of memorable performances. During his 13 years in the league, he had not only cemented his place among the game's all-time greats, but also evolved as a team leader.
He's always been one of the most, if not the most, talented player in the league. But his leadership, you know, getting people on the same page and level as him has grown unbelievable.
Let's go, Congo!
Play with Kobe is just something special. The way he talks to you just make you feel like, I gotta do better. I have to do something. I need to help this guy, because the way he helped me is just special.
Hey, they're gonna use misdirection. They're gonna try to get you looking over here, and then they're gonna hit Lewis back on the short side.
When I first came here, you know, he just helped me with the offense, you know, helped me with the defense, what we supposed to be doing, just constantly talked to me, you know, was in my ear. He's unbelievable, you know, when it comes to, you know, being a leader.
It's a lot more communication back and forth. It's a lot more, you know, with young guys, talk to them, put your arm around them. Let's see how we can make this work together so that we can be the best team we can be.
Well, Steve is sitting right there. Listen, Steve is sitting right there. I want you to go there early. Listen to me. Go there early.
He's grown a lot as an individual, as a teammate, as a leader. I think it all starts with him, and he understands that we need to help him. He needs us to do our part in order for him to be successful or this team to be successful.
Part of being a superstar is also learning how to delegate and regulate and facilitate, not necessarily just what you can do, but help your teammates on that journey with you.
Well, after the 25-point loss in Game 1, the Orlando Magic had a couple of days to think about it and adjust as we arrive at Game 2.
Let's get my mind ready to go. Game 1, it's a disaster, as everybody know, but it's over with. Can't go back in time and get it back. You don't ever win a series or lose a series with one game, so that's the way we look at it.
The Lakers had better bring the same intensity that they brought in Game 1. Because the Magic is going to be ready.
And we're here again with a situation like we have been throughout the playoffs, having to bounce back from a disappointing game.
Paul.
Yo. What's up, Greg?
But the Magic were ready to put Game 1 behind them, and they came out firing.
Here's Richard, defended well right side, buried the three ball. Sweet Lou shooting it well. Lewis again open, puts it in. Rashard Lewis, his fourth three-pointer, and he has 18 points in the second period.
You know, Lewis is the fire right now. You what, two in a row, three in a row? Right, got an offensive rebound, little Jay Corden three, right? So we got to put out that fire.
And now the Lakers would catch fire with a spark from their defense.
Lewis hands off to Howard, then Ariza knocked it away, has the steal. 4-on-2 Lakers, Fisher shuffles Ariza, touch pass Bryant, who hammers it in.
Nice pass inside, but somebody got a piece of it, or Howard couldn't handle it. Bryant goes right at Ray for Austin, kicks it out, Fisher for three, bang. Largest lead of the first half for the Lakers.
Here's what I've seen so far. We're playing exactly the way we played in Game 1. When's it gonna change?
What changed in the second half was a surge from Dwight Howard.
Howard, and there it is, his first dunk of these finals. It took him till the third quarter of Game 2. Shot clock down to 6. Gasol against Lewis. Left-handed blocked by Howard.
With Howard making his presence felt, Game 2 became a tense drama as the Magic rallied down the stretch.
Turkoglu sees the shot clock down to 6. Turkoglu looking. Turkoglu pulls up, puts it up, knocks it down. A two-pointer for Turkoglu.
Orlando had tied it, but they still needed a stop, and it would be no easy task.
They're facing the great closer, Kobe Bryant.
The Lakers with a chance to go for the win, with the game tied at 88.
Bryant, Fisher, Gasol, Ariza working for Los Angeles with Odom who triggers. To Gasol, back to Odom.